She creates beautiful paintings on canvas, but not using paint. She uses yarn. We're in the studio today with Joyce O'Brien. And Joyce, thank you very much for letting us come in. And your artwork is a little bit unique. Tell us about it.
I do pictures with yarn. I use a needlepoint canvas, needlepoint stitches, but other than that, that's the end of the needlepoint. It's really an art.
How did you start this? How did this come about?
My husband and myself traveled in the 60s, and we went long distances, and I had a lot of time that was to spare. I came up with the idea of combining my interest in oil painting and my interest in sewing, and combined the two to try and make my own pictures.
Had you had a background in oils?
I had not. I took a course in high school in oil painting, but it had already been an interest.
All right. Take us from when you started out with this. You never paint anything on the canvas and then do needlepoint, which is what a lot of us do. So how do you get your ideas, and where do you start?
I see a picture that I think, ooh, that would make a really nice picture. And then I use a camera shot for my model. Then I use my yarn as my medium.
What kind of yarn do you use?
I use the Paternaen Persian wool.
And you don't have anything marked. This is all freehand, I guess you'd call it, on the canvas.
Yes, that's right. Absolutely freehand. I may start in the middle of the picture, usually to get a idea of how it should be. I would probably start in the middle of the building, and where you go into a building, then that would determine what size the rest of it should be. Sometimes I get clear to the end of a canvas and almost run out of canvas. Yeah, because I have nothing to go by but my eye.
And you blend?
I blend my yarn, yes. It comes in three strands. Then I separate the strands, and sometimes I stay in the same family of color. Sometimes I will go to another, and it will make a different color than you're used to seeing if you mix two different families. And so then I use two strands.
And shadows, how do you do shadows?
Shadows I do, that normally is, again, in the same family. Although sometimes if, like, I'm making a brick, then I will have two separate families, and then you have to have the light and the dark of the same two families. So it would be four different colors mixed together for your light and your dark.
How long does it take you?
This particular took me over 600 hours. Yeah, they take a long time. They're very tedious. Sometimes I have to tear out, but you can't tear out only once. Then your canvas gets weak.
That's true. Now, what about, you like buildings and architecture?
I do. I don't really know what draws me to landmarks, yes. I really do like landmarks.
And now you've got a show coming up. So are you always looking for the next project? Do you, like some of us needlepointers, we have 10 projects by our side of the chair. Do you just keep working on that one?
I keep working on the one. And I really like to take sort of a break after I do one because my hands, it's very hard, very difficult. And so I try to make a break. Right now I'm getting ready for my show at the Ankeny Art Center in August.
Okay, and then any other projects coming up for you?
Not at this time.
Okay, and you said you wouldn't mind. Tell me how old you are.
I'm 87 next week.
So that's an inspiration in itself. Joyce, thank you very much for letting us come in today, and you'll keep us in stitches for a long time, I'm sure. Thank you very much. For KCCI, I'm Molly Cooney in the Artist Studio.
Joyce's needlepoint will be on exhibit at the Ankeny Art Center from August 2nd through the 26th. For more on her work, or if you're interested in buying the Des Moines Skyline piece, which is for sale, you can email her at jhalfpint@msn.com.